What's good, y'all? Welcome to an episode of Buzz Boys. The Hornets, they did it again, man. Third time to charm, three times in a fucking row, bro. Yo, this is a completely new team than before the deadline. The season has now started. We're now 3-0. Like, dude, this is special, bro. This is special. This team, the aura, everything about it just feels different. The depth. I mean, the game isn't over when the bench comes in. It's remarkable to watch these players actually be able to do something. Like, yo, we can actually play basketball. Yo, this is special. I don't give a fuck. I know what our record is, dude, but this just feels special. Like, to go 3-0 at home, and I mean, the Grizzlies won. It easily could have been a fluke. You got the momentum after trade deadline. Everybody's riled up or whatever. People playing harder because they just got traded. People playing harder because they didn't get traded. So, like all that. And the Grizzlies, they were hurt as fuck. It was what it was. The Pacers coming in was a real test. That was a real test against a good team. We took care of business. We took care of business. Then the Hawks come in. We whooped their bro. We whooped their ass in the fourth quarter. Yo, what the yo? Yo, nah. This is special, bro. This is special right here, dude. This is our first double-digit win of the season. We had our biggest lead of the season, 22 points. This isn't a fluke. This is three times in a row. This is against a team that are higher than us in the standings. I mean, what, Pacers are sixth, Hawks are what, ninth or something? This means something to me, man. I'm not gonna take too long because it is late. The game was a little minute ago. I'm a little behind getting this video out, making it. But damn, I'm still riled up as if I just got done watching it, man. Like, this is a special team. Anyways, let me get into the video, man. The first thing that I have, Miles attacking. I've talked about it for the last few videos. Actually, before I get into the video, I just want to give a moment of appreciation to all the new subscribers. The channel's growing a lot this past week. We almost had 800 subscribers. We were just on, like, at 720. Now we had like 795 or something like that. So I just want to say shout out to, get the fuck off of my screen, bro. I just want to say shout out to y'all, man. It means a lot, and welcome to the family. And also, I'm using my computer this video, so like I got the stats up and shit. So like, if you hear a droning sound, please comment down below and let me know that you hear this background noise, because I won't use it again. Now into the video. Miles attacking, getting downhill. I've talked about it so many videos, so many times. He can shoot. I'm glad that he can shoot. He shot 3 for 6 from three tonight. That's 50%. I'm glad that Miles can do that. But I want to see you get downhill and score, dominate with your size, your athleticism, get to the free throw line. He was 4 for 4 from the free throw line. Okay, you can shoot, cool, but it doesn't mean you have to rely on it. It doesn't mean you have to fall in love with taking those shots. Take them when defense gives them to you because they respect your driving ability. And if you do get fouled, you're gonna go to the free throw line and make them. And I mean, for pretty much the first play of the game, he comes down, he like tries to dunk. Ends up having to try to lay it up, misses it, gets his own rebound, puts it back up. That's what I want to see. And then now, I'm going to get a little off track here, man. Miles, I really needed you to dunk the fucking ball, bro. I had a slip for like $500, and all I needed was Miles to dunk the ball, bro. And he just would not dunk that bitch. He just would not dunk that bitch, bro. That shit hurt. That shit hurt. That shit was real pain. Real pain. But anyway, we move. Miles came back down, had the little push shot, and just get in the paint, bro. Just get in the paint. Next thing, Trey fucking man. Dude, we done hit gold. We done struck gold, boy. What the fuck? Nobody could say they expect this. I expected offensive production around 12 to 15 points, something like that, because I knew he was going to get the opportunity. And I know that he could play in OKC. It just you know, their team is deep as fuck now. They got all these draft picks. They're turning into players. Some of the older players, I mean, he's not old, but he's on the team for 3-4 years. Some of the players from a few years ago, they kind of getting pushed to the bench. That's all that happened there. He didn't lose his talent, but this, I don't think he was ever. 21 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists. Bro, he just was coming off a damn near triple-double the other night. Comes back, does it again with 21 points. Last time he had like 9. Bro. And I'm getting off track because literally all I have written down is just his rebounds. But still, this is my, you know, my notes as I'm watching the game. I'm making notes. So somebody, like, I'm taking these notes as I'm watching the game. I didn't know it was going to turn into this. But I did bet on him, though, because I knew he was going to go off. But anyway, his rebounding is so impressive as a 6'3 guard. It's so impressive. And, I mean, it's like, dude, this is amazing for this team because here you get a Terry Rozier who's 7-8 years younger. I mean, they're both 6'3". But, I mean, look at the rebound. Look at the passing. His perimeter defense. Bro, we got a steal in Trey Mann. Like, seriously, he could be a starting shooting guard going forward. He's that damn good. Now, it's still, do you want a 6'3 guard out there beside LaMelo? But LaMelo's big enough to where it's like, you can get away with it, especially if he plays defense like Trey Mann does. And his rebound, he's amazing. It's amazing for a guard. Nick Richards comes down, has the and-one. I liked his impact that he brung tonight. Now, Nick still does some little stuff that just pisses you off. Like, he just does the most random, stupid stuff when you watch the game that just ticks you off. Nick, the ball is right there. Why are you waiting for somebody else to grab it? You're the center. Get the fucking ball. Stuff like that pisses me off. What else is it that he fucking does? He can't set a proper screen 4 years into the NBA. 3-4 years into the NBA. Set a fucking screen without getting a fucking call, bro. Why can't you just fucking stand there, bro? That's all you gotta do. Damn. But when he's not doing that, pissing me off, I'll take 12-7. I'll take that. Now, obviously, you want to see some blocks and stuff from your center, but I'll take 12-7. I'll take it. Trey Mann, right back to him. 3, boom. Get us going. Like, we don't have these terrible first quarters anymore. We have too many people that can score the ball. Man hits the 3. Then Cody to Brandon hit. Cody, didn't even hesitate. Brandon, boom. And I love watching Brandon shoot because he never hesitates. Soon as it touches his fingertips, it's gone. Cash. Nice pass, Cody. Trey Mann comes down, hits the deep ass 3. And that's when I knew he was finna go crazy. I knew he was finna have a game after that shit. Deep ass 3. Like, we really got this dude for fucking washed, broken, made of glass Gordon, dude. Oh, man. <that's... laughs> And some picks and Mitchich and Breton. Like, yo, that shit is funny. Pleasure doing business. Oh, man. Then after Trey hits the deep 3, what does he do? Comes down, throws a lob to Nick. And I mean, he just plays so effortlessly. It's like the game comes to him like that. He talked about his post-game conference. He's like, hey, I mean, you know, I see that Nick's athletic. I just throw it up, let him do the rest. He doesn't really think about it. Just pick and roll, boom, all right, boom, there's the ball. You jump high, go dunk it. That simple. He doesn't overcomplicate the game. I love it. And then right after throwing the lob to Nick, he comes down, get his own dunk. Like, dude, from the jump, it was a Trey Mann show. Like, and in my head, bro, I'm like, he's getting a triple double tonight. I hate that he didn't. But he only played 29 minutes. And it's like, bro, Steve Clifford gotta stop hating. Let the motherfucker get his triple double. Why is he only playing 29 minutes? I mean, we did whoop their ass, though, you feel me? We did blow them out. But, I mean, he had one foul. I'm playing that dude till he gets his triple double, dude. He could have got that shit. I don't know. He did stop passing. He did. He had like six assists in the third quarter to finish with six. But anyway, after that, Brandon hits the three. And the momentum of the back-to-back-to-back plays, I don't know how we blew that lead in the first quarter, bro. We had, I think, an 11, 12-point lead in the first quarter. Playing great basketball. Boom, 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 boom. Don't know how we blew the lead. Mitchich has a beautiful pass to Grant. I was like 2 minutes left in the first. Mitchich comes down with the lay. I love the change of pace that Mitchich provides. Because he plays at his own pace. It's not a snail pace, but he plays at his own pace, bro. But it's so effective. He's the perfect veteran for this team, bro. I love it. Like, I'm so happy with this team post-deadline. There's nothing that I can point to and say, like, bro, top to bottom, everybody does something. I love it. I love it. And then going into the second quarter, boom. Nick coming from Grant. Everybody's moving the ball. Everybody, like, dude. Then you got Trey from Curry. Everybody's moving the ball. And it's like, dude, these people have literally been together 5 fucking days. They passed the ball way more than the Hornets teams that have been teammates for fucking years. It's insane. And it really makes you wonder, did these former teammates not like each other? Was it a chemistry problem? Because this right here throws a bunch of random people together, and it seemed like they had more chemistry, dude. I mean, seriously. But anyway, Curry getting downhill, and I mean, I think that's something that he has shown that has been, I mean, don't get me wrong, I've seen Curry, all the teams he's played for, I've seen him over the years on the Mavs, on the Nets, but he can actually get downhill, you know? Like, he's just not a pick-and-pop guy. He can actually put the ball on the floor and get some crafty buckets. I mean, he was 1-for-4 from three. You know, you want to see him shoot better than that, and he obviously will. But he's still 4-for-8 from the field, still 50% because he can get downhill. He can hit the midi. He can get to the basket, like, all of that. So it's actually, like, refreshing, like, to watch him drive. Like, okay. More than a shooter. Bertans hits his one honorary three a game. He's still been struggling, man. 3 points, 1-for-4 from the field, 1-for-4 from three. Somehow still has a plus 13, plus minus, just because we were out there whooping ass in 13 minutes. And his minutes were the lowest out of everybody's involved in the trade. He was not playing at all in OKC. Like, Trey Mann played sometimes. Bertans was not playing. And when he did, it was 2-3-4 minutes, like sparingly, super sparingly. So, you know, I'm going to keep giving him the benefit of the doubt because of that. I do want to see him provide more than just shooting because I think he can provide more than just that. But it is what it is. Brandon comes down, hits three. I mean, the three-point shooter of this team, what did we shoot tonight? It had to be at least maybe 40%. 40.5%. I know we had to have a good shooting night tonight. 40% as a team from three, you take that every night. I'll take that every night, bro. I mean, and the timing of the threes, I mean, we never let the game get out of reach. Even when we gave the lead back to Atlanta, it never was more than a few points, really. Like, the three kept us in the game. They were so well timed. Like, I mean, just the heart of the team, we didn't want to lose. We did not want to lose. Cody, the contested fade, I did not like that possession. It was similar to, I believe it was last game I talked about it, where Cody ends up dribbling out the whole fucking shot clock and ends up taking a tough shot. Now, for the second time, he made it. And I guess it turns to a cool little highlight or whatever, but watching the game, I don't want to see shit like that, especially when the ball's hopping around and everybody's playing selflessly. I don't want to see selfish possessions like that. I don't want to see that shit. Cool, you made the shot. I don't like that shot. Brandon M1. I mean, bro, people were talking about coming out of college. Brandon's gonna struggle with M1s. I remember that shit. I remember talking about it and saying he was gonna get many M1s this season. He's 2 week to finish and da 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 da. And I was disputing that in my summer league videos. I remember it. Man, he comes down, gets the M1. I believe he had a few this game. He might have had, yep, he had another one in the same quarter. Has the M1, it's about 3 minutes left. Grant comes down with the lay. Brandon hits the three from Cody. And then Brandon M1. It's the spurts of this team that is making us so dangerous, where we look like the Hornets from that 2021 year, where you just had so many threats. I think we had like seven people, which was the highest in the NBA to have 20-point games or maybe 30-point games, where you just have so many threats. And it feels like that, but we play defense too. And not to mention, we held the Hawks for under 100 for the first time all season. We held somebody under 100. We held the 76ers to under 100, but we lost still. Yeah, man. Brandon had some special plays in the second quarter. It was like, it was the Trey Man show in the first, and in the second, it was Brandon. And in the third, it was like it was Grant and Curry. Trey Man comes out, you know, he did his little thing to start the third. Then you got the Grant tip in. He just around. He had a double double tonight, 10 boards. He's 6'6", just like PJ. But it's about high motor player every night. He's disputing calls. He's arguing with the refs. He's on the ball fighting for loose balls. He's doing all of that stuff. That junkyard dog mentality, all of that is what we need. He has to tip in. Curry hits the corner three, and every time Curry hits a shot for this team at home, it is going to make the crowd go crazy. I think it's going to be like that the entire season. For as long as Curry is in a Hornets jersey, him hitting a three is always going to drive the crowd crazy. I think so, at least. It's Curry with 30 on the back hitting a shot in Charlotte. It's always going to make the crowd go crazy. So he hits the shot. And then like a few minutes later, he ends up in a bullshit foul call situation. They challenge Steve Clifford is like, I think they said 19 of his 27 challenges or something, like a really good percentage on challenges. So he challenges it, overturns. It was a bullshit call from the fucking jump. Grant hits the layup and he just did a lot tonight. I felt like in the post, but kind of from his midi. I mean, he had 12 field goals tonight, which is by far, I feel like the most. Well, he had 12 shot attempts. I apologize. Five threes, seven shots from two for him. It's a pretty decent amount. Like, you look at the box scores from his last few games, like he kind of was just kind of shooting threes, getting tip ins here and there. Him and Mitchell play really good together, in that bench unit. You can tell they've kind of been practicing a little bit and getting that chemistry. But yeah, he has the lay. Then Grant hits the three, and then Curry has the contested midi, and it's like, bro, he's just a shooter. Curry is just a shooter. It doesn't matter where it's at on the floor. Like I say, he's really a three-level scorer, and it's like I'm just getting to see him more. So it's actually kind of like refreshing to see. And that's what talk about how we really locked Trae Young, and I talked about that at the end of the Pacers video, that I think that we could win this game because we always lock up Trae Young, which we did as usual. What did he have tonight? I honestly have no clue. He had fucking 12 points. Now, yes, he had 12 assists, but you hold Trae Young to 12 points and 33% from the field and 25% from three, damn it, you're probably gonna win the game. And Trae Young averages his worst, lowest field goal percentage versus any team. It's against the Hornets. He literally shoots 37% from the field against us. We lock him the fuck up. Always have. For his entire career. I don't know why, but we just always have. Moving into the fourth quarter, Miles hits a three. I believe it was in the corner. I remember it. And this is when kind of Mitchell and Miles kind of take over in the fourth. Like, it's like every quarter kind of had like spurts where just guys showed up and just kind of took over the quarter. Miles is a three. Mitchell comes down with the lay. Grant had baseline drive with the lay. And I mean, just the way that we were just attacking the basket, which is what I wanted to see us do with no Capella and no Okongwu. I mean, now Jalen Johnson had a great offensive game, but defensively, attack them, bro, until they show they can stop it. I think their other center fouled out. I don't even know what his name was. Then Mitchell hits a three, Miles hits a three, and the game was over at that point. Ended up with a 22-point lead, biggest of the season. In the first double-digit win, and I mean, damn, bro, like, we really won three in a row. All of a sudden, everybody's talking about, yo, can we make the play-in? Can we make the play-in? Like, the whole organization, fan base, everything has been rejuvenated, everything. Dude, all of a sudden, like I said, all of a sudden, yo, let's check the standings. How far back are we? What's going on? Everything feels like a possibility now with this team. And this is still no LaMelo, no Mark. How could you not feel like, oh, shit, we could do something. Let's look at the standings. I mean, right now, three-game winning streak. Everybody around us is on a losing streak. So anything is possible. Right now, we're 10 games back. We're 10 games back out of that play-in, man. I mean, the Hawks are 7 games under 500. I mean, we're fucking 20-something. We're back. We're back, dude. But, hey, anything can happen. You never know. The Hawks on a 2-game losing streak. The Nets on a 2-game losing streak. The Raptors on a 3-game losing streak. We're on a 3-game winning streak. The Wizards are on an 8-game losing streak, so we don't have to worry about anybody catching us. They're in the tankathon for sure. But we can start trending up. If the Raptors keep losing, we keep winning. Next thing you know, we're 12th. We're still looking up. And stuff might mess around and become realistic for us. I don't know. I'm not going to say never, because you just don't know what can happen in the NBA. You just don't know. You look at the Cavs, they went on a 10-11 game winning streak. You never know what can happen, bro. And, I mean, I think LaMelo's going to be back sooner than later. I would say probably within the next 2-3 games, he should be back. Especially, I know he wants to play bad. He sees this team actually doing something. Yeah, man. I'm going to keep this video short. We're approaching 23 minutes. I appreciate you giving me your time. And that's a whole TV episode. My throat is starting to hurt. I've beaten this sickness. I'm not really sick no more, but my throat is hurting just talking for 23 minutes straight. real quick, though, I do want to talk about the stats, man. Brandon Miller, 26 points. I mean, and like Grant Williams talked so highly about him. He's only been around him for a few days, but he was like, I see Jason Tatum in him. I see Paul George in him. And I mean, dude, a rookie, 26 points, just one rookie of the month. Well, for the Eastern Conference, rookie of the month. Dude, he's been special, man. And then you got, man, 21 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists. I really want him to get a triple-double, and I believe he's going to get one soon because he's been close. And I know he's still trying to get his stamina up, and he talked about that in his post-game conference. He was like, you know, that Pacers game was better than the Grizzlies game as far as stamina, but he was still kind of tired. So, you know, that might just be why Clifford is kind of monitoring him, and he's not playing 30-plus minutes yet, because he definitely deserves to, in my opinion. Miles, 17 points. He had a rough shooting night. He did pick it up towards the end of the game, but he has, at a certain point, I checked, he was shooting like 22% from the field or something. So he ended up shooting in like the 30s or something. Let's see. Come on, dude. Embarrassing me. He ended up shooting 38% and 50% from three, but at one point he was like playing like shit. Nick Richards, I already talked about, 12.7 rebounds. I'll live with that. Grant Williams, 15-10, double-double. I love his impact, man. I love his impact. I love the way that he gets respect from the refs, something that most Hornets players don't. You know, Grant gets to the yelling and screaming out there, and all of a sudden, calls get changed. I mean, we've seen it in back to back games. He got what did he get called on him tonight? Oh, the kickball. Jalen Johnson kicked the ball, then Grant kicked the ball. They said Grant tried. I don't know what the call was. But long story short, Grant gets to yelling, screaming, call change. Last game, Grant Williams hanging on the rim, gets a tech. He gets to talking his shit, call changes. I'll take it. I'll take somebody that gets respect. We need that. And he is the vice president of the Players Association. So maybe it's that. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe it's just the fact he's been on winning teams. Who knows? Mitchich, 13 points, 5 assists. I love that off the bench. I would take that every game. Hopefully he can keep that up. I love it. I love it. He doesn't shoot much, 4 for 9. I love it. Cody, and even Cody, 6 points, 7 rebounds, 4 assists, balanced game. Very balanced game. Very balanced game. 3 for 6 from the field. You know, didn't try to do too much offensively. I can definitely live with that. I'm very happy with this game, man. And there's no way you can't be when you look at the score, bro. And, I mean, we beat them by 23, dude. Yo, I'm in love with this team. Let me see who we play next, man. And I know this video is running long, so if you're giving me 27 minutes of your time, I appreciate you. It definitely means a lot. Let me see the schedule real quick. We got the Jazz. Yeah, we're about to hit the road. We're about to hit the road. We got the Jazz coming up. Well, the All-Star break is coming up, so we do have a week of a break. So, you know, take some time to enjoy this video, soak it up. I'm actually going to drop a collab video with my boy Darian and everything Hornets. So we're going to be doing something. We were talking about it, so keep your eyes peeled for that. Yeah, we got the Jazz coming up. We got the Warriors, the Trailblazers, and then the Bucks. So yeah, we're gonna end up on a little road trip here. 4-game road trip. And it's gonna be interesting to see how this team plays on the road. This is gonna be the first time on the road. Since the trade, 3 home games. You go 3-0. Okay, what can you do on the road against a team like the Jazz? Against a team like the Warriors, who are scorching hot right now on a 6-game winning streak. They're beating the Clippers right now, about to be 7. You know, and it's a team who's been facing a little bit of injuries. You give them another week to get healthy. That's going to be a true test. It's going to be interesting to see that Curry versus Curry dynamic. It's going to be interesting to see. And then Trailblazers, that's definitely a winnable game. The Jazz and the Trailblazers game is definitely winnable. The Bucks game is winnable. We always match up well against the Bucks, and now this is an even better Hornets team. We're on the road versus them, and they come to us. So even if we lose, we get a chance at redemption. And, I mean, I'm not too scared of the Bucks, man. I'm really not. I'm really not. Dame Lillard's been playing like shit, and Doc Rivers can't coach for shit. And, I mean, we just lost to him not too long ago. So I definitely feel like we can shake back now that we got a different squad. Anyways, I'm about to wrap this up because I'm at 30 minutes and my fucking throat is hurting. I appreciate y'all for giving me your time. If you watched at this point, 30 minutes, comment down below and let me know that you made it this far, man, because that's real love. I definitely appreciate that shit, bro. Like, I'm so serious. It means the world to me for people to give me this much of their time. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. If you already think that you're subscribed, double check and make sure you're subscribed. I've seen some people comment that, like, oh shit, I thought I'd been subscribed for the longest time, and they weren't. So just subscribe, like, comment, you know, so the algorithm can do its thing, keep getting me up. I appreciate all the love, man. The views have been going up literally every video with the consistency it always does, but it still feels good all the time. To be appreciated. So welcome to the family. If you're new to the family, if you've been a part of the family, I appreciate you. I love you. I love all my subscribers. And like I said, stay tuned for that collab video. It's going to be coming over the All-Star break. And I'll catch y'all in the next one, man. Peace.